Hi there, welcome back to another video. If you aren't familiar with me, hi, I am Baker Betty. I'm a professional baking instructor and welcome to my channel. I hope you will stick around here for a little while and subscribe. Now today we are going to talk about bread baking pots. So I bake a lot of sourdough bread and artisan style crusty breads, and my preferred way to bake those breads is in a Dutch oven or a closed pot. And the reason for this is when you put a lid on the pot when it goes in the oven, it traps in moisture from your bread into that pot, which is going to keep the crust moist, and it will allow your bread to fully rise and get a really nice oven spring before that crust sets and it won't rise anymore. So commercial bakeries typically have ovens that have steam injectors in them. So they can inject steam into the oven, they get that really nice moist environment, and they get a really nice rise on their bread and get that nice crackly thin crust. But most home ovens do not have this option. So I find that baking in a Dutch oven or a closed pot is really the best way to create that environment in your home oven. Now, some people do prefer using a baking stone or a baking steel, and then they create a steam bath underneath the baking stone in their oven. And I will link a video below to somebody who uses that method and shows you the setup for it. But it is just not my preferred method. I find baking straight in a pot is just much simpler, and I prefer the results I get. So today I want to talk about all of the different pots that I have that I bake with. I actually have 5 different types. Prior to 2020, before everything shut down, I was teaching a lot of sourdough workshops and other types of bread workshops here in Chicago. And I would bring all of my pots to use to bake breads in for those workshops. And so I do truly use all of these and enjoy working with all of these. So let's talk about each one and kind of how they're different and why you might want to pick one over the other. Now, I will be leaving links down in the description box for each of these options that we talk about today. So let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, I'm not going to beat around the bush here. I'm going to start with my favorite pan that I own, and this is the Challenger bread pan. Now, full disclosure, this pan was gifted to me about a year ago. They sent it to me to try out, and ever since I received it, I have been using it and loving it. Now, this pan is made by a bread baker for bread bakers. So this pan was made by Jim Challenger. He is also local to the Chicago area. And he made this pan to sort of address all of the things that bread bakers are kind of annoyed about with other bread baking options, with Dutch ovens or different pots that are used typically for bread baking for a home baker. So the first thing is the size of it. It's a really, really wide, and it makes this a very versatile pan. So you can very easily bake a boule, a round loaf in this, but you can also very easily bake a batard, which is an oval loaf in this pan. You can also bake 2 demi baguettes side by side in the pan like that. Or I've also used it to bake focaccia right in the base of the pan. So it's super versatile in the shape and size and what you can bake in it. One of the other major benefits of this pan is that the base has really low sides, which makes it much easier to transfer your loaf into it when you have preheated your pan. And you don't have to risk burning yourself quite as much as you do with a pan with really high sides. Also, the way that it's designed, it has a very, very firm seal when it is shut. So that's going to trap all of that air in really tightly. You're not going to lose any of that steam that you want to keep inside when you're baking with the lid on so that you get the best oven spring. It also has a second set of handles here on top that allows you to pull the cover off really easy while your bread is baking. Usually you'll take the top off for the last little bit of baking to get, you know, a nicer, darker crust. So that makes it really easy to pull off. If I'm home baking and I only need 1 loaf of bread, this is the pan that I'm going to bake with. If I need 2 loaves of bread, if I'm baking a couple loaves, I'll use this one with one of my other pans. So hands down, this is the pan I always go to first. Now, really the only cons I would say there is to this pan is the price. If you're looking for a really affordable option, this is probably not the pan for you. This pan is the highest price of all of the pans we'll talk about today. It's typically sold for $295 when it is full price. It is currently on sale for $225. I'm not sure how long that sale will be going on, but I definitely don't think this pan is overpriced for what you get. It's made in the USA, it's handcrafted by a small business, it's super versatile, super high quality, it will last you a lifetime if you are a bread baker that bakes a lot of breads, and the price is going to work in your budget. I definitely believe that this is the pan you should get. But that said, there are a lot of other really good options that are in a much lower price range. So let's talk about those. Okay, next up we have two different styles of Lodge Dutch ovens. I have a full cast iron Dutch oven, and then I have the enamel version of the Dutch oven. Now both of these are 4.5 quarts in size, and I would say that's probably about the smallest you would want to go for a pot to bake your bread in. You could maybe go to 4 quart, but really 5 quart or 6 is probably a better size. I bake lots of boules in these and it's fine, they're not too small, but I wouldn't really recommend going smaller. The cast iron Lodge is the very first pan I bought when I started baking bread, and this is the lowest price point of any of the pots we're going to talk about. Depending on what size you're gonna get, it typically runs anywhere from about $40 to $60. This pan was $40 and it worked great for me. I used it for many, many years before I got any other pans, before I started teaching and, you know, kind of trying a lot of different things. So the biggest pro of this option is really the price. You're going to get a really nice pan that functions very well for a really good price. The cons of this pan might be just that it's a full cast iron pan, and so it takes a little more effort to care for it. I don't find it to be a big effort, but it needs to be dried immediately after you wash it. You need to keep it oiled so that it doesn't rust. And so, you know, all of those things just require a little bit more care for your cast iron pan. Now, my other pan here is a Lodge enamel Dutch oven. So it has a coating on the inside of it that makes it a nonstick coating. So one of the things that I love about this pan as compared to my cast iron Dutch oven is just that I find this one to be more versatile. I use it for lots of things other than baking bread. I use it to make stews or to do braises. And it's not to say that I couldn't do that in my cast iron, but the reason I prefer the enamel is because of the lighter color of the finish. I can more easily see what's happening in my pot. Also, it's easier to cook acidic things in an enameled pot than in cast iron. Acidic ingredients aren't really recommended for cast iron because they kind of take off your seasoning on it, and sometimes they can kind of make things taste metallic. So I just find the enamel pot to be, you know, a little bit more versatile. So if you're looking for a pot that's more versatile, I would recommend looking for an enamel Dutch oven. I really like the Lodge ones. Depending on what size you get, again, these run anywhere from $60 to $80. So they are a bit more expensive than the cast iron ones, but again, you get more versatility with them. They also come in all different kinds of colors, so they're gonna look beautiful sitting in your kitchen. I also have a green one of this same exact Dutch oven. And you know, they come in red, blue, any color really that you want. So the other thing to keep in mind with traditional Dutch ovens is that they do have higher sides. So when you go to transfer your bread into them, it's usually easy if you put your bread on a piece of parchment paper first and then you transfer the parchment into your Dutch oven. That makes it a little safer if you do like to bake in a preheated Dutch oven. I do both. I sometimes don't preheat my Dutch oven, but the more and more I bake, the more I do prefer baking in a preheated Dutch oven. I just find that I get more consistent, better oven spring. So the higher sides of a Dutch oven are just something to keep in mind safety-wise. If you're somebody that burns yourself very easily, you're gonna wanna be very careful with this, but I do have an option coming up that doesn't have the high sides that's more affordable than the Challenger bread pan, so that might be a better option for you. So this is going to be very similar in function as something like a Le Creuset or a Staub Dutch oven. Now, those are great options as well. They work very, very well. But a Le Creuset of this similar style is gonna be upwards $300+. And so personally, I love the Lodge. I think they're great. They are very well made. They work very well. So that is my recommendation on that. Okay, next up is my Le Creuset oval casserole dish. Now, I believe this one is 4 quarts in size, and I can bake bread that is the same size loaves as the ones I do in my Dutch oven. So this 4 quart size does work, but these also come in larger sizes. And this pot was purchased, I purchased this because I wanted to start baking batards, oval style loaves, and I purchased this before I had the Challenger bread pan. So this is a versatile pan. You can, you know, use it in the oven for a braise or for a casserole or something like that. But really, I use it only for baking bread. And now that I have my Challenger, Challenger is my go-to on that. But that said, you know, this is the Le Creuset. It's $115 for this casserole dish. Their Dutch ovens are much more expensive than their covered casserole dishes. So if you do want to own a Le Creuset, this is a bit of a more affordable option. And I really love the shape of a batard loaf, an oval loaf, and so this is a great option for that. It's also really beautiful. This is the cream ivory color, but this comes in several colors as well. Okay, next up we have our Emile Henry bread cloche. So this is a little bit more unique in that it has this really flat base and then it has this dome that goes over the top of your bread as it's baking. So full disclosure, this was also gifted to me by Emile Henry, and I use it all the time. I love it. I use it in my bread classes all the time, and people find this to look really fancy and kind of like they're really an official bread baker, so that's kind of fun. It does come in different colors as well, and kind of the nice thing about this is it's also low profile like the Challenger bread pan. You can easily put your loaf in here without having the high sides of kind of burning your hands, which is sort of what you have to deal with the Dutch ovens. If you do bake in a preheated Dutch oven, you have to be careful about burning yourself. So this has got the low profile base. You can easily put your bread in here if this is preheated without, you know, risking burning yourself too much. They also do talk about on their instructions that you don't even need to preheat this, that you can put your loaf right on it, put the cover on top, and then go straight in the oven without it being preheated. I personally do still preheat it. I think it gives me a better rise, but that is an option as well. And then the other kind of benefit that this option gives you is the base is designed that you can actually cut your loaf right on it. You don't need to move it to a cutting board or anything. And then after it's cut, you can put the cover back over it for storage. So that's another option. It looks beautiful. It'd look really pretty sitting out in your kitchen. This runs about $135, but you can very easily bake a boule in here. It's also advertised to be used for rolls or bagels or anything like that. I personally have not tried that, but I think this is a really beautiful option, especially if you're getting a gift for somebody. This is something that a bread baker would find very exciting. Now, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. That always helps my channel. And if you have any questions about any of these pots, feel free to leave those down in the comment section. I will always try to answer them. And I also have a whole playlist of videos teaching you how to bake sourdough bread. So if you're new here, I'm gonna put that link down in the description box. I walk through the whole process of how to get your sourdough starter going and then how to start baking with it. There's lots of videos in that playlist with tons of information. So check that out if you are new to sourdough. And again, if you aren't already subscribed, please hit that subscription button. I would love to have you here, and I will see you next time with another baking video.